Well, the Hindus believe some when a black cat crosses the way in front of you, it's bad luck, and if a pregnant woman sees an eclipse, that is bad luck. Why is that?
You see, the religion that we come from emphasizes two things, and sometimes the Hindus forget, and that's why they pay heavy price. He says, one thing to look at your teachings, your scriptures, etc., and try and understand them. Second, how do you interpret the teachings of your religion? He says, using this thing that we possess, all of us possess, this thing. You must always interpret your religion using your common sense, your own common, not your, you know, your teacher's common sense, but your own common sense. Give full, that's why I'm saying, give dignity to yourself. You get it wrong, it's your mistake. Play, live with it. Do not just, you know, say that, oh, it's written in some scripture, it's written up here, so that's it's fixed. Don't do that. This religion allows you to interpret religion as time goes on and say, this doesn't seem right, this seems right, and continue to evolve, continue. We are not fixed, you see. We are a living religion, so we are continuing to evolve all the time. So it is telling you the way you evolve is to continue to challenge, if necessary, question the things that have come out from your tradition and see to what extent they make sense to you. My answer would be this. If there are any aspects to your religion that do not make sense to you, there's no real logical reason that doesn't satisfy you, then my comment, this is a very strong comment, is to challenge it and reject it. Reject it. Your religion allows you, gives you permission, saying that if it doesn't agree with, look, I use this language on Asta a few times. It's not just the Shruti, your scriptures of authority that you fall back on. It is yukti, your power of rationality to try and interpret the religion and continue to recognize its limitation, its contextual aspects. So this idea of not just Shruti, but yukti, use this. This is the best tool you have to guide you. Life is tough. Religions are tough. So use this rational faculty to try and come to terms. If there's anything, for example, the Hindus kind of can be blamed for, ancient and modern, is superstition. Superstition. And they continue to infect our society. They create a lot of harm, cause a lot of distress. Imagine, you know, somebody, you know, in the family, you know, is saying, look, you can't do this because it's written somewhere and you can't go out now because the cat passed by, so all, you know, you can't stay in the home now. And the person has lost his job because of that. So superstitions have to be challenged of every form. But also, let me just tidy up a little bit and something else. Sometimes these things were adopted for other reasons than you are aware of. And there's one that I want to talk about, and it's this. You see, you'll find in the Hindu scriptures, the Shastras, especially when talking about the solar eclipse, when the sun gets covered up, they will say an auspicious day, inauspicious. Don't go out. Pull the curtains and stay home and worship and meditate and don't go out until it's finished. And this would be very worrying. Why are they doing it? Oh, because Rahu and Ketu are swallowing the sun, it's a horrible day. But that doesn't make sense. Surely, Rahu, Ketu, where did they come from? The moon just came in front of the sun. So nobody's swallowing the sun. Surely it's not right. There was another reason behind it, whereby that other reason is the reason why we adopt it as a religious injunction. What was the other reason? Think about it. And I gave a talk like this to Muslim college about 2 weeks back. I talk and imagine teaching Hindus at Muslim college. I do it very regularly. And they say the same thing. They have the same issue. When there is an eclipse, pray, worship. Don't go out like that. I said, do you know why they are doing it or why you are doing it? There's another reason. Not because Rahu Ketu are swallowing the sun. Look, your common sense, there's no Rahu Ketu. Where did they come from? And how do they swallow the sun? There'll be trouble. So it doesn't make sense. So reject straight away. The answer is this. For thousands of years, millions of people who are not aware of what is actually happening in the skies, and there's a farmer, say, plowing the fields, middle of the day, suddenly the sun disappears. It becomes pitch dark in the middle of the day. And they're plowing the fields. They don't know about solar eclipse. They don't know. They've never heard the word. And they look up in the sky. What happened to the sun? What happened to the sun? And the sun is gone, and they're staring. What's happened with the plow in their hand like that? And soon the moon begins to move away, and there's a light coming out. They can see a ring. And they keep staring. Wow, never seen stuff like that. They keep staring. Do you know what happens if you stare like that for 30 seconds? The retina of your eyes are burned forever. You become blinded. millions of people over thousands of years have been blinded because they don't know solar eclipse, you don't look at it, it's going to destroy your eyes because it's very deceptive. It's very interesting, exciting, you stare at it. And I tell you, 30 seconds will destroy the retina. You become permanently blind. Nobody can, you can, even in modern times, you can't get this, you know, recover. So it's a major issue. So what the people of religions did is this. This is my interpretation. Look, I'm using my common sense to try and say, why did they do it? Why is it so crucial? In order to protect the eyes of this kind of, you know, gullible people who don't know what's happening, this is called solar, they don't know, you don't look at it. And they're going to be tempted to look at it and become blind. So warn them to stay indoors. So you get the panchang out, yes, Surya Grahan, in the house, don't go out, protect. So religion was used as a ploy for this reason. So you should be able to judge. There are other health issues which become incorporated as religious injunction, but they're mostly do with health. Allow for that. Don't say this is horrible. But once you know the, you say, how do I come to this kind of conclusion? Because I want to keep this switched on. Think for myself. If I went into all the shastras, I'll get 10 different interpretations. And then I go to the shastris and they'll give me 100 different interpretations. So rather than all that, I'd rather use my own common sense and come to terms. Suppose it doesn't make sense to me, I will reject it. My mentor says, reject. Anything that is negative, don't swallow it. You'll be destroyed if you start swallowing things that don't make sense to you. Reject if necessary. So my little youngster, I'm telling you, if things don't make sense to you, if a cat has walked by, say, why poor black cat should be, you know, this is color discrimination. Why not white cat as well then? This is the way you challenge the issues. Why not white cat? What has black cat, poor black cat done? He's already black cat. What do you want? You can't park. So this is color discrimination, and then walk through. Look, suppose you get it wrong, so be it. Suppose there is some real reason, you don't know about it. But if you don't know about it, you're going to follow it. Doesn't matter. Always challenge things that don't make sense to you. Remember that all your life. This will help you, it'll make you a very strong individual, very upright, very clear thinker. Then you can make a good contribution in society. Otherwise, you are rattled up inside, you are broken up inside. What contribution can you make? Challenge things that don't make sense to you.